Congratulations, Senator Mark Leno, for being the first openly gay man to serve on the U.S. Senate. As gay men who came of age during the Stonewall era and part of the larger LGBTQI community, we should be especially proud of all of the brave individuals who have worked hard to advance the cause of human rights despite opposition from those who use religious excuses to deny them. Now, this open video letter is with regards to the most basic of human rights. I read in the news recently that you had been honored at a popular San Francisco restaurant with the hanging of your portrait there. Meanwhile, outside of the restaurant, a young man was protesting genital mutilation of children. Jonathon Conte is one of the Bay Area Intactivists who worked hard at great personal and financial expense to gather voter signatures well in excess of the number needed to put an initiative on the ballot that would have protected children from genital mutilation in the city of San Francisco. Senator Leno, you took part in passing a bill that blocked this initiative from happening, in effect suppressing the will of the people and condoning genital cutting of non-consenting minors. You were quoted as calling the initiative an affront to religious freedom. Senator Leno, what does putting a baby's penis in a clamp and cutting part of it off have to do with religious freedom? What does this have to do with sexual freedom? Is this child being sexually violated? What religion is this boy? Honestly, Senator Leno, is your support for religious freedom any different from that of Rick Santorum, who uses that excuse to squelch basic human rights? Wherever genital cutting is forced upon children, it leaves in its wake trauma, heartbreak, and destruction that is never acknowledged by those who promote it. Have you any idea how many children and the adults they become have been seriously damaged by this forced genital surgery? How many have had to live without a penis or with part of the glands missing because of a botched circumcision? In California recently, a young man took his own life because he was so distraught with having to live with the results of a botched circumcision. But you smile and attend photo ops and squelch the efforts of human rights activists like Jonathon Conte. I spoke with Jonathon recently and he had this to say.
It's immensely disappointing to see Senator Leno, as an individual who has fought in the past for sexual freedom, on the side of the sexual oppressor when it comes to protecting boys and the men who they become from infant circumcision. Non-therapeutic, non-consensual genital cutting in any form, such as the case of routine infant circumcision, I see that as the antithesis to sexual freedom. For him to deny men the right to their complete sexual experience and anatomy, while at the same time posing as this crusader of sexual freedom, is just incredibly hypocritical and disappointing to me. I mean, I'm of the opinion that people who don't support the most basic of human rights, such as the right to bodily integrity, are not people that we should be electing for public office. So as far as I'm concerned, I would like to see him out of public office, and I would prefer to see someone in who does respect that all individuals, regardless of gender, should have the right to grow up whole and unharmed.
The effects of trauma on the brain, post-traumatic stress disorder, stem from severe pain. What are we doing imposing this on infants? Prompted by one of his Intactivist students, Jewish-American Harvard professor of biology and Nobel Peace Prize winner George Wald wrote a remarkable essay questioning and ultimately denouncing circumcision. Jewish-American psychologist Ronald Goldman studied trauma and long-term psychological effects from infant circumcision. He also questioned circumcision from a Jewish perspective. Jewish-American sexologist Hanny Lightfoot Klein details the myths and misinformation that societies that cut children use to maintain these harmful traditions. Jewish-American scholar Leonard Glick wrote about the history of circumcision in Marked in Your Flesh. Questioning and ending circumcision is certainly not anti-Semitic. Many Jewish parents today are naming their sons in ceremonies without cutting them. There is one last aspect of this issue I wish to address. You are quoted as stating, "Having lived now 30 years through the HIV/AIDS epidemic as a gay man in San Francisco, I am well aware that circumcision is a frontline defense against HIV and other sexually transmitted diseases." A frontline defense? What about condoms? Do you really believe that having had part of your penis cut off when you were a baby is a frontline defense against sexually transmitted diseases, including AIDS? How did circumcision provide a frontline defense for all the gay men who were cut at birth and died with AIDS? The current push to cut African infants, men, and boys to prevent HIV is perhaps the largest scale medical fraud in human history. To use San Francisco as an example, as you have, when the vast majority of the gay men who died of AIDS were circumcised, only illustrates that HIV is not stopped by circumcision. Now, these may be difficult concepts for someone to believe who needs to believe the myths and the lies that support forced genital cutting when they were too young to protest or protect themselves. Perhaps it's easier to smile and ignore the man with the sign, but this issue is not going away. This is an issue of sexual freedom and human rights. I asked Jonathon Conte if he would continue protesting.
Yes, as long as we have leaders who believe that it is acceptable to subject children to genital mutilation, Bay Area Intactivists will be protesting.